We're kids. We have the time to take those ideas and make it into reality. So do a little something every day to reach up to that goal, but it's okay if it doesn't happen overnight, because nothing successful ever happens overnight. My name is Gitanjali Rao. I'm 15 years old and I go to STEM school Highlands Ranch. The biggest piece of inspiration was definitely hearing about the water crisis in Flint, Michigan, and how many kids my age were basically drinking a poison every single day that caused lifelong damage to their mental capacity, their vital organs, and their normal growth, all just because they were drinking water in their daily lives. It's called Tethys, and it detects lead in drinking water faster and more inexpensive than the current tools. And it uses something called carbon nanotube sensor technology to help detect for lead in drinking water. I actually heard about, you know, the work of nanotube sensors on MIT's page, where they were using it to help detect for hazardous gases in the air. And I put that back into my work and decided to use carbon nanotube sensors to detect lead in drinking water. Even though it was, you know, a little bit difficult in the beginning, after doing a lot of courses, after reading through a lot of papers, it soon became instinct to me and kind of recognized this idea that innovation doesn't have a deadline. So when I start going, I can keep going and there's no one stopping me there. The app that I'm building right now, which helps with cyberbullying, is one of the ones that I actually started out with an idea for the longest time. I actually wanted to create a happiness detector. You know, it actually took me about 2.5 years to completely build it. And some of the biggest challenges that I faced was, you know, building it from scratch, because I was still learning about how to completely code apps, how to work with artificial intelligence, which all of Kindly is actually built on. But since then, it's gone a long way, and it really proves to show that perseverance is just how you take it. Since then, the application to detect bullying is actually now out there for people to start using, but hopefully I'm going to, I guess, furnish it out even more and have it so that people all across the world are continuing to use it. You know, there is that gender barrier, and that makes it even more difficult. Just because I am 15 doesn't mean that I do have ideas, that I do have goals. I might not have a PhD, I might not have a degree, but I have that same drive within me that anyone else has to solve problems.